Somebody you might already know. That's my man Wes Borland over there. Ripping it up on his Jackson. Action Jackson.
Hi, I'm Wes from Limp Bizkit. We just got a bolted steel Jackson Warrior that they're going to let me take with me when I leave here. Actually not. We're at Sonisphere, and I'm at the Jackson cabin tent portable home area thing. And Limp Bizkit's been on tour in Europe for the last 3 weeks. The tour is going amazing, and Jackson was kind enough to give me three warriors for the tour, actually. And one is a black one that's this same, a very similar model to this, and one is a gray one that's a very similar model to this. One is a white one with a black bevel, and then I have a black warrior that's a Japanese-made warrior. And all three have been fantastic and are probably the nicest guitars I've ever owned. So I'm thrilled. I'm brand new to Jackson, and I'm absolutely thrilled to be part of the company and playing them on stage. I've actually had many Rhodes V's that I've been using for the last 5 years because a friend of mine gave me a 1981 Randy Rhodes V that was his first guitar in his band, Ross Robinson, actually, the producer. And ever since as soon as I got that one, I went, wow, these play amazing. And so it's just sort of started my love for Jackson. Here I am, 5 years later.
Perfect timing.
Thanks for to the Limp Bizkit fans that are coming to shows. Thanks for making our shows heart pounding and full of love and strangeness and kick drums. I don't know if that's a Limp Bizkit fan, but I certainly can't hear a kick drum in the background. It's probably going to ruin this interview. But thank you guys for accepting me back into your hearts after 8 years.